widely regarded as one of Europe's finest treasures, beautiful Lake Como rests peacefully in Italy's northern region of Lombardy. At her Dublin studio, Italian artist Iole Bortoli shares her connections with Lake Como, from her childhood memories to her forthcoming art course to take place in Nobiallo by the lake.
Well, first of all, I was born in the area of the Lake Como, in the province of Como, and I was born in a very small village, and my parents were bartenders, so I was basically born in a bar. And so all my memories are, you know, of that small village and growing up there. Although the best memories are connected to the village where my mother was born, and where I spent all my childhood summers holiday with my grandmother. She was the one who was overlooking. And I was there with my sister and all my cousins. So strangely enough, my memories are more connected to the village in the mountains than my village where I was born. Probably because that's where I was the happiest.
Looking back over the years, were there signs there as a child that art was to become the passion that it is for you today?
Yes, it was. And I think it's, you know, it didn't start so much as art, as in drawing and painting, but more as craft, because that was very prevalent in the village. Like every woman made rugs and every man wove baskets or made tools by carving. So it was very much present. You could say that every single adult in the villa had a creative output, you know. So I think I learned it there, because I moved a lot in my life. For example, when I started going to art school in Italy, I went to do pottery first, so that's where I started. And then I moved to graphic design and fine art. So at that time, fine art and graphic design was the main thing. Pottery before, weaving before, and they all stayed with me, so they're all part of what I do.
And in the art course next week in Lake Como, which media will the students be using?
Painting and drawing, that would be the main thing.
Okay.
Which is, in a way, I think is my strongest love, although I love all the art forms, but painting and drawing is my strongest. First of all, I believe that art itself is an act of transformation, because whatever you have in your mind, even if you work with the charcoal and you have something in front of you, it's never what you think you're going to do. It always end up being something not different, but sometimes you say, well, it's not what I had in mind, and yet it's still beautiful or it's still satisfying. Because I think that in the act of doing art, a transformation takes place, which comes from inside, from your heart. And I think that's what is the healing part of art. Because especially when you mention the healing aspect of the art, is perhaps the way of working that I resisted the most. You know, when I remember, it was actually a group from rehab who asked me to facilitate them in Doliri. And I didn't want to go, I didn't want to do it, because I didn't think I was ready for it, I didn't know what I needed to know, so there was a certain resistance, and in fact it turned out to be now the 90% of my work is with other people, and is very much in the healing aspect of the art, so something I didn't want to do and now doing every day.
I've no doubt that the peace and beauty of Lake Como will be the ideal environment for us all next week.
Well, I'm sure it will be, I have no doubt about it.
Iole and her students expectantly arrive at Lake Como and are greeted with a dramatic landscape of majestic mountains, stunning vistas, and lush springtime vegetation. Each of the participants shared their hopes and expectations for the week ahead.
I think mainly I hope to soak in the views and the atmosphere and the culture, the sights and sounds, smells, tastes, because food is very much going to be part of the week. and to see some sights that I wouldn't normally see, and then to maybe produce some beautiful art from it.
It was a totally different experience for me, and I hope they give me a chance to my creativity. Okay. And I just also want to take time out from all things what I'm doing, and so relaxing here, so you can actually relax and have time for reflection, and it's just...
I suppose often I find it difficult to create the time, to put the time aside for kind of creating things. And this gives me the time and space to do that. It gives me the time to think and relax into it.
Well, I suppose what I'm looking for is personal space to create, to have time out in a safe environment, and not feeling under pressure, and, you know, sort of a sensorial experience as well.
Well, really just kind of open to experiencing new kind of landscape and lighting. Just try different techniques and mediums, really, you know, so very much open to the new experience of different approach. So just enjoying that aspect of it, you know.
Located in the idyllic village of Tremezzo, Villa Carlotta is a luxurious palace with botanical gardens, fountains, and a museum, which offers a warm welcome and inspiration to all comers. Drawing reference from the lake scenery, participants were encouraged to visualize merging their form with the life of the lake.
Because I think that the environment is extremely important, because when the people come into a room and the room is prepared for them, laid out for them, you send a message and say, I care about you, and I care about the time you're going to spend together. And then about the group itself and the dynamic between the facilitator or the assistant, because very often I bring assistants, and the people are working with me, creates a dynamic which has to be safe, which has to be creative, and it has to be that has to facilitate expression as much as possible. They produce something and they say, where did it come from? You know, and that's really beautiful for the facilitator to witness.
The village of Verena is a peaceful and tranquil setting, rich in romance and history, and, as with all lakeshore towns, can be reached by ferry.
Villaggio Villa Carlotta, Tremezzo, Lenno.
That there is a very busy road that goes all along Lake Como, but because of that, in a way, the villages have been saved, because there is no space to build big roads, so the road is also very peaceful.
Lake Como is renowned for its mild and humid subtropical climate. The lake is swept by seven winds, the Tivano from the north in the morning and the Breva from the south in the afternoon are the main two. In the past, this type of rowing boat, known as Lucia's boat, was used to bring goods to market. In 1827, Alessandro Manzoni wrote the romantic novel Promessi Sposi, where a woman named Lucia escaped in a boat like this. The book has been described as the most famous and widely read novel of the Italian language. On each day of the course, Denise and Vanda prepared delicious and nutritious homemade, authentic Italian food. This is a specialty dish named pizzocchiere, and that's Gino in the background helping out. It has to be said, pizzocchiere was relished by all, with no leftovers. As the Art to Heart Week for the Senses draws to a close, Yole and her participants reflect on the healing experience of the week in Lake Como.
Yeah, I was very, very pleased. I think because what I've learned is to plan it to a certain extent and then to let things evolve and in more in an unplanned way. I mean, that way it's easier.
Finally, just about yourself, did you learn anything this year? You were here before. This is your second year. Have you learned anything about yourself from being in the course?
I think to be more flexible, you know, simply because what is nice about coming back in the same, and I think this is the first time I repeated the same venue, okay, is that I think perhaps, going back to what you asked before about the surprise, I think maybe the very nice surprise that the people recognized us, you know, so the people from where we rented the rooms or the people in the restaurants, you know, and they just welcomed us. And you know, even the women say this morning, we'll say, we'll see you next year. Okay. You know, so that was really lovely.
Excellent. Well, I hope we all enjoy our final day here, Yole, and it's all thanks to you. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Okay.
Well, it was a great week. It was a fantastic week. I was here to fulfil the requirements of my art course, and that's a box ticked for definite. I was here as a creative assistant, as doing some research and lots of other functions, so major box ticked for me even just in that regard. But it truly was a week for the senses, seeing Italy through the eyes of Yole, who's a native, and the dramatically beautiful scenery, the lake with its reflective qualities, the depth and the inkiness, and yet the reflectiveness, so which really inspired me to be reflective, and other participants too, I think. Taste of authentic food from Vanda and Denise, the feel of the wind on your skin, the smells of the wisteria and gorgeous vegetation. I never realised just how beautiful the flora and fauna of Italy were until this week. So I think it has been a week for renewal and healing, certainly nurtured my creativity and given me plenty of memories and plenty of nutrition for my ongoing artwork. Overall though, the week really reinforced my belief that art is a transformative process, and Yole spoke a bit about that, and I felt myself inspired as she spoke and reminded that that is what's going on when we're reflecting nature when we're creating art, and people have done that since day, you know, going back to the cavemen and before. It's been a great group of people to be with for the week, and I would love to come back at some stage and do it all again, perhaps differently, but definitely come back.
It's a hard one and it's an easy one at the same time, because I think I was saying to you at the beginning of the week that I hadn't actually produced very much, and I still haven't produced very much, but actually the experience has been incredible, and I'm working on a few personal projects, and I felt that I've really moved those along. In terms of doing a bit of writing and coming up with images to accompany them and stuff like that.
Lovely.
So I think I was saying to you earlier that it's often it's a cumulative effect of all the experiences that you bring with you somewhere else. And I think just being on the water here has definitely shifted something for me.
There was a lot of walking, a lot of travelling. It's like I was travelling back to myself, you know, after, you know, work and stress and the time out and getting lots of sort of artistic nutrition, if you like, for when I go home and just bring it back into my life, you know, and hopefully paint and draw. Lots of ideas now.
Oh, I really enjoyed that week with Viola, and we did a lot of art, and I get more confident.
Mm-hmm.
And all beauty of Ireland, you know, all beauty of the lake and the trips, what we did, place, okay. what we see, really inspiring me.
Okay.
And food is great.
Yeah.
And lovely people around. So okay. It's just really enjoying that week, and I would say it was fantastic. I would do it again.
Well, quite a lot really, I suppose. Just another better understanding of the landscape that's in Lake Como. And the lighting and colour. Just interesting stories about the people of Lake Como and the architecture.
Okay.
I mean, the list goes on, I think, really. There's just so much.
Okay.
Come here for every month of the year and still find more to see in Lake Como. So
okay.
It's been a really fascinating experience, I have to say, overall.
The opportunity to create this documentary is something for which I will be forever grateful to Yole. It has been a privilege to observe just a glimpse of the wonderful work she does through Art to Heart. I have learned so much during this, my first production, and I hope others will also be inspired by Yole and Art to Heart through viewing this.